triumph of marketing over matter or talent over taunts. Probably somewhere in between. But the staying power of girl power is undeniable. Relaxing before one of their American dates, the Spice Girls, a foursome since Jerry Halliwell's abrupt departure in May, are in a confident mood.
You know, we always stay true to ourselves, basically. You know, we're just up there having fun. And, you know, everybody's been saying to us, is this the end now? And we have got so much to do. We're writing our third album at the moment. You know, we've got this big tour of the US. You have got to reach on up,
never lose. The North American leg of the world tour is not only a sellout, its panache has received favorable reviews.
The response that we've been getting from our fans has been so overwhelming. I think that this is going to be a really memorable part of the tour.
You know, we found, you know, the families, they come along and you have the dads sitting there and they're like, oh, I've got to bring my kids. By the end of it, they are up and dancing more than the children are.
What about in Miami the first night? It was so funny because there was a guy, obviously, was his two kids' dad. And he was up on the chair and he was giving it loads, wasn't he? Yeah. And his kids were like that. Damn.
So I think we've gained a few more fans since.
The parents and young girls were spending their nights out on the street corner to get, you know, to get tickets to these shows. It's pretty exciting. It hasn't been like that in years.
Adolescent antics, provocative poses, the occasional royal flush. In short, attitude with a capital A has kept the girls in the headlines.
What else have you got here?
Yeah!
A lot of rumours that you're pregnant. No, none of us are pregnant.
You're not old. You know, you're as young as the girl you feel, and I'm 25.
But it's one of the greatest moments in my life.
Aye.
Second greatest moment.
It is correct that I'm meeting with Ambassador Hamdun this afternoon, really to follow up this issue. If the Spice Girls want to have a rendezvous with me, I'm not aware of it, but I wouldn't mind.
Yo, I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. Don't tell me what you want, what you really, really want. I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. Don't tell me what you want.
It's less than 2 years since Wannabe propelled the Spice Girls into the limelight. It was their first single, a number one in Britain. The album Spice followed suit in both Britain and the United States. The girls claim inspiration from a pantheon of strong women.
You know, very strong females who we really respect. We always say Nana Cherry was fantastic. Tina Turner, Madonna. I mean, the list is endless. I mean, Gloria Estefan, who
I
remember.
Anita Baker, I like.
Anita Baker.
Their rise and rise appalled some. 60s music icon Phil Spector described the band as music's antichrist. An attempt in Spain to recognize the sociological impact of their music went down none too well. But in the words of Oscar Wilde, there's only one thing worse than being talked about, and that's not being talked about. Girl power was part of this self-promotion, hardly a philosophy, but it fitted the image to perfection. And it was tailored to appeal to the band's core audience, preteen and teenage girls.
Girl power.
We've created this movement. It's more than a band. It's like feminism from the 60s revitalized for the 90s. We feel that it's needed now more than ever.
But
this time around, you can wear your wonder bra, much makeup as you like, but you know, still have intelligence, have some balls.
And it was Jerry Halliwell, a.k.a. Ginger Spice, who gave the band much of its assertive edge. Her departure has renewed predictions of the Spice Girls' imminent demise. The four remaining have closed ranks.
We had 2 hours, didn't we, to completely, you know, take over her vocals and alter the choreography. And it gave us all a kick up the bottom, I'd say. You know what I mean? And it's been good. We've been doing really well. I'm really proud of all of us.
I think, you know, when, you know, we first found out about Jerry, we were all really shocked. And it was very strange at first, because, I mean, we've been a five-piece since as long as we've been together, like for 4 years. But now it's 3 weeks ago now, and really it feels like it could be 3 years ago, doesn't it? It's like we're really comfortable as a four-piece. I mean, the show's come together, it's taken on another level.
So does Ginger's exit hint at the Spice Girls' mortality?
I don't think it has adversely affected the group. Ginger has had a head start to work on her own solo endeavors. And I think we'll eventually see all the other girls go their separate ways, but I think they're going to ride the wave as long as they can.
The girls themselves seem to relish riding the wave, but are looking to new horizons.
Individually, we want to grow, as well as collectively. And on the next album, you know, there's going to be a few changes there. There's going to be a few, you know, solo songs, you know,
I'm doing one next week with Missy Elliott. I'm recording one next week. So you have to keep your ears open for that one.
It doesn't mean that, you know, even though Melanie's going off next week, that is nothing. It helps all of us, really. It's not, you know, just that she's going to go off and do solo.
We've all done, like, little bits.
Yeah, it's little bits, and we're still sticking together.
Strengthens.
Yeah,
yeah,
definitely.
So long as the venues fill, the albums sell, and the royalties roll in, the Spice Girls will probably be with us.